Welcome to the Programming with PiWeb API course. In this video, we're going to introduce you to PiWeb API, which is a RESTful web service to interact with the Pi system. We will talk about the use cases, advantages, go over some characteristics of a RESTful web service, and how to communicate with PiWeb API through making HTTP requests. PiWeb API belongs to the OSIsoft Pi Developer Technologies family of products. This family of products is designed to support implementation of custom applications to work with the Pi system data. For example, there is the Pi SQL framework, which includes the Pi OLEDB Enterprise, Pi ODBC Driver, Pi JDBC Driver, and others, which allow users to specify SQL-like query to read or write from the Pi or AF server. You might also be familiar with the Pi AF SDK, which is a .NET library that allows very easy implementation in a .NET programming language. In this course, we're going to talk to you about PiWeb API, which is a REST-based API service. PiWeb API is built on top of the Pi AF SDK. It is cross-platform, which means that any programming language that can make HTTP requests can use PiWeb API. This makes PiWeb API useful in a wide variety of applications. It supports multiple users. While the Pi AF SDK is designed to be run within the context of a single user, PiWeb API supports multiple users out of the box. It is also extremely easy to deploy because it does not require a local installation on every client machine. All these characteristics makes PiWeb API good for web applications, mobile applications, and other types of applications that you'd like to develop. An integrated part of PiWeb API is the Pi Index Search Crawler. It is the default feature installed on a PiWeb API machine. It's usually installed on the same machine, but other configurations are also possible. What the Index Search Crawler does is it periodically crawls the Pi and AF databases, it gathers information, and it creates indexes for them. That means that users can search for data later on through going through the local indexes instead of going to the remote Pi or AF server every time. This often leads to performance improvement of commonly used queries. You can search by names, by point attributes, by descriptions, or you can configure other types of point attributes to be indexed. Now let's take a look at the PiWeb API through the browser. So if we open up a new tab in our browser, we are navigating to the main homepage of PiWeb API. Here I have a remote installation of PiWeb API instance on the machine DNG Lemon Web. A few things that you might notice is, first of all, the help pages. If you're new to PiWeb API, it is often useful to go to the help page to take a look at the Get Started guide. You can also see the list of links to different resources. For example, you could take a look at the SS servers or the AF server, the data servers or Pi Data Archives, or the search crawler configuration. As a RESTful service, there are several characteristics of PiWeb API. Some characteristics include that it is stateless, which means that no client context is being stored on a server between requests. If we make another request to PiWeb API, for example by clicking on the link to go to asset servers, this second request is completely independent than the first. Other characteristics include that resources in PiWeb API is identified by URLs. Earlier, we just click on the link to go take a look at the list of AF servers. In this case, I have two AF servers configured for this PiWeb API instance, DNG Lemon AF and DNG AF 2014. Also, PiWeb API is resource-oriented, which means that data sent to the client is a representation of the requested resource. In this case, the requested resource is the list of AF servers, and the data that is displayed to us is JSON object. JSON, or JavaScript object notation, is human readable, as you can see here. It consists of attribute value pairs. For example, web ID is the attribute, and this is the value for the web ID attribute. Another example here, name is an attribute, and this is the value for name. We'll be looking at JSON object a lot throughout this class while interacting with PyWeb API. So far, we have been using the web browser to interact with PyWeb API. What is the browser doing under the hood? What the browser does, it sends HTTP GET requests to the PyWeb API server. Upon receiving this request, the PyWeb API server will send an appropriate response back to the browser, and the browser, which is the client in this case, will show the PyWeb API server response on the HTML page that we have seen earlier. Apart from requesting resource from the PyOAF system, you might want to do other types of operation. For example, if you like to create elements or attributes, you will need to specify other type of HTTP request. To specify the type of request, you can use HTTP verbs. For example, you can use post or put for creating resource. You can use get to read, patch for update, and delete for deleting resource. And we'll go through how to make each of these HTTP requests in details in later videos. Finally, let's talk about some prerequisite for the course. Ideally, you have a working Py system, which includes the Py and AF server. We're going to show you Py System 2015 in this course. You should have a working instance of PyWeb API. In the next video, we're going to go through brief configuration things to note for development environment. And we'll be using PyWeb API 2015 R2. And finally, if you like to follow along the coding portion of the class, you need to have a development environment. We'll show you using Visual Studio 2015, but feel free to use any development environment that you like.